based on the given sentence, based on the given sentence, pick the option that corresponds to, pick the option that corresponds to what human parents would say. Pick the option that corresponds to what the human parents would say. The sentence is, while his parents circled around, while his parents circled around, raising a proud cackle. Yes, Arpit? I'm just saying, like, you have to pick the option which corresponds to what parents, Indian parents would say. The statement given is, while his parents circled around, raising a proud cackle. This is a given statement in your lesson. At this situation, the parents, Indian parents, will they say something like this? Choose the option. Option number one is, well done. Well done. Option B is, oh no. Third option is, ready. Third option, ready. R-E-A-D-Y, question mark, and a sign of exclamation together. Ready, ready. So what does it, you are able to make out, find out. And the fourth option is, really. Really, R-E-A-L-L-Y. Okay, first write the next question also. Don't tell me the answer yet. Let everybody think in the class. Question number two is, which option tells the image, which option corresponds to the image nearest to skim the waves? Nearest to skim the waves. Skim. So here I have got four pictures. Nearest to skim the waves. So there are four pictures. I'm going to show you four pictures. In which picture the meaning is skimming the waves? Getting? I guess you understand the meaning of skimming. What is skimming? Yes, one is like one. Let me give you four words, because picture I can't show you. Very small pictures are there on my book. Let the one picture is the one where a boy is swimming. Will it be skimming? The second picture is where a fish is inside the water. The third picture is where a bird, some unknown bird, it's on the surface of the water. So which out of these three? C option will be correct. That is skimming, which is on the surface of the water, as if one is walking upon it. Okay? Okay, next question is, imagine that the young girl attended a workshop. Imagine that a young seagull attended a workshop on inspiration and confidence building. Workshop on inspiration and confidence building, and received a couple of pieces of advice. Imagine that a young seagull attended a workshop on inspiration and confidence building and received a couple of pieces of advice. Now choose the option that reflects, but choose the option that reflects these pieces of advice. that reflect these pieces of advice most relevant to his situation. Got it? Most relevant to his situation. The option number one is the early bird catches the worms. The early bird catches the worms. The early bird catches the worm. It's a proverb actually. W-O-R-M. Proverb. It's a proverb actually. The early bird catches the worm. It simply means, it is simply a importance of punctuality. Okay? When you reach early at some place, you are always able to do better. It doesn't matter, second option. It doesn't matter what others are doing. It doesn't matter what others are doing. But what matters the most is what you are doing. It doesn't matter what others are doing. But what matters is what you are doing. What does it simply mean? Mind your business. Yes, mind your business. Because it is your work which will affect your life. Third option is, everything you have ever wanted is on the other side of fear. Everything that you have ever wanted is on the other side of the fear. And last option is, knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. Knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. Knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. Clear? Now options are, these were also options, but you have to select the option number one is 1 and 2. Option number 1A, 1 and 2. B option is, right. B option is 2 and 3. C option is 3 and 4. And D option is 1 and 4. I'm repeating, 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4, 1 and 4. 1 and 4. Third and fourth. What was third one? The one answer is, okay, we'll discuss it later on. One more question you write. Now, which of the following feelings did the young seagull not feel according to the given context? Which of the following feelings did the seagull not feel in the given context? Got it? Not feel. Clear? Which of the following feelings did the seagull not feel in the given context? Option number one is, point one is sad. Number two, incompetent. 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 Third point is excluded. 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 Number four, ungrateful. 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 Then fifth point is inspired. 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 बेटा अभी आंसर तो पूछा ही नहीं मैंने. नेक्स्ट वन इज जेलस. जेलस. GEALOUS. एंड नंबर सेवन इज एंक्शियस. कैन यू गिव आंसर नाउ? नो, बिकॉज द क्वेश्चन इज येट टू कम. ऑप्शन नंबर वन इज 1, 2 एंड 6. ऑप्शन नंबर वन इज 1, 2 एंड 6. क्या बोलूं दोबारा से? ऑप्शन नंबर वन इज 1, 2 एंड 6. डी ऑप्शन इज 2, 5 एंड 7. 2, 5 एंड 7. सी ऑप्शन इज 2, 3, 7. 2, 3, 7. And D option is 4, 5, 6. Okay, now fifth question, very small one. Select the appropriate option for the following.
The four is to guzzle as nibble is to dash.
It's written like this. Got it? The options are number one, chew. Write what I'm saying first. Chew. A is chew. B is savor. S-A-V-O-U-R. C is peck. P-E-C-K. And D is gulp. G-U-L-P. G-U-L-P. Gulp. I'm repeating the options. Chew. Savor. S-A-V-O-U-R. Third option is peck. P-E-C-K. And D option is gulp. G-U-L-P. Got it? These are very simple questions which I guess you people might have done in NTSC also. The word is to guzzle. What's the relationship between these two? Its meaning, devouring is guzzling, eating. Nibble is to, nibbling, you understand? Yeah, the, you know, mice, they nibble. Thus, eating style of mice is nibbling. Sparrows also nibble. I guess seagull also nibble. I don't know exactly. But the point is, nibbling is eating like a mice. Mice nibbles, very small bites, very, very small. Okay, so nibbles synonym is, but the relationship of these two words is synonyms. So the relationship of these two words should also be synonyms. So the word which is nearest to meaning to nibble is peck, P-E-C-K. Yes, last pincher. Arpit, stand up you. Done all the answers? Have you done? Okay, now let us read the paragraph. Then you people side by side do the answers. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sisters, perfecting him in the art of flight, teaching them how to skim the waves and how to dive for fish. I'm reading out the passage so that you are able to find the correct answers. One thing is sure, that the answers are not directly in the passage. You have to understand it. But the thing is that you need to know the whole chapter side by side.
The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sisters. Aray, I'm reading out the paragraph.
I'm reading out the given passage. He's writing the paragraph. Anyways, this is called presence of mind. The day before, second last venture, I'm writing the names for the ones who will be sitting at home from tomorrow. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sister, perfecting them in the art of flight. So what does this line mean? Third last venture, Prabhnoor, I guess. Yes. The meaning of this one-lined sentence. Stand up. Kushi, write the name, Pita, those who are not able to speak up now, because these children don't want to study. What's his name? Japjot. Okay. Tanushka, give the answer of this line. Where is it written that he was feeling very bad? Not from your side, just tell what is written. So Seagull had seen his parents teaching his siblings the art of flying and skimming, right? So he had seen his parents doing this the whole day. The parents had spent the whole day teaching their children the art of flying and skimming. Anything else? No. Sit down. How to skim the waves and how to dive for fish. So he had seen his parents teaching three things: flying, skimming, and diving for catching fish. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring and devour it. And the parents were teaching how to do something, and one of his brother had been successful in learning and was even able to achieve something. Some children are so quick in learning. They not only learn, they do more than what is expected. So that brother of the seagull had not only learned to dive to catch fish, but had actually got a fish. Got it?
So he had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring. Herring is a kind of fish. And devour it. So from here, devour word, you might have got it. Devour is?
Ate.
Gulped. So devour's synonym is gulping. And one more synonym is already there with you. Ghazal. Standing on a rock, while his parents circled around, raising a proud cackle. So when the brother ate, got something, when the brother did something what parents had done, then what did they do? The parents circled around, raising a proud cackle. So from here, you've got to know, like, what did the parents do when he did this? The parents did a proud cackle, means they said, well done. Your parents are all Indian. What would they say in this kind of situation? Will they say, oh no? Will they say, really? Will they say, what? What is the word?
Ready.
Or will they say, well done? Well done. Okay, when your parents teach you something and you are able to do it, they of course always say, well done. Good, great, wow, something like this. And they're not shocked, really.
Okay, so the question was, what do the Indian parents say? Okay, most of the students from CBSE appearing for 10th board will be Indian students. Okay,
so let's finish it off. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his cowardice.
So what had the whole family done? The whole family had taunted him with his cowardice. So who was taunted? Seagull. For what was he taunted? Because they were considering him to be a coward. Why was he considered a coward? Okay, that girl says because he had fear of flight. What is it? Till now. If I give you four options, Khushi, write on the names better. That boy with the Japjot. What's your name? Parth. So tomorrow be at home. Rumani, yes. Okay, Khushi, tell Aditya sir today these names. These children will be sitting at home tomorrow. At home, at least they won't be able to talk with a screen. So when you are coming in the school, when you are not getting benefit of the direct teaching, then take the indirect learning. Why to come? See how many difficult situations we are undergoing. See the way I have to mask up myself. It's so difficult for us to speak like this. It's only for you people. But you are coming here with mask, you're speaking. The moment you will start learning, listening, learning will start taking place. Just one paragraph from the whole story we are doing, but it will help you get a lot of information. It will give you an incentive to do the chapter all. So anyone who is found talking in the class in any period will be asked to stay at home and study in a safe mode. And that boy, Parth, go to that side. And Sahaj, you are not only disturbing yourself, you are disturbing the other, the one who wants to study. Go to that side. Is there some vacant desk? No.
Okay, so we were having one point. So imagine this eagle attended a workshop on inspiration and all. So if the seagull would be attending an inspiration on confidence and inspiration, then what will she say? Which option will be relevant to her? So what was the first option? The early bird catches the worm. What does it mean? Be punctual. Reach some place well in time. Okay? Then you are always in an advantageous position. Right? Second option was, is it applicable to this situation? It's not about coming early or late. Second option is, doesn't matter what others are saying about you. Okay, the brothers and sisters were saying, were taunting him. And as you sometimes, you people also say, like, because that person discouraged me, I can't do now. The moment some friend says that you can't do it, leave it. And you say, I got discouraged. No, I will not do it. Does it matter? Did it happen with this bird also? Is it applicable to the bird? Yes. His brothers and sisters were taunting him. So we can apply it for him. That if his brothers and sisters are saying something to him, he should not mind it. Like that boy Keshav. Write his name also. Last boy Aryansh. Write his name.
What was the other option? What do you see this? Everything you do is on the other side of the sphere.